Welcome to this week's edition of Real Recruits TV. Here with Damon Easley, you may recognize the face. He's a 17-year Major League Baseball player, All-Star in 1998. And Damon, you know, you've got a lot of our kids that we have helped with Real Recruits so far that you've actually coached. I want to talk about a couple of them. First of all, Bryce Johnson, you know, he's a left-handed pitcher, also an outfielder. Just kind of assess what you see as his strengths.
Bryce is a strong defender, plays all three outfield spots, throws the ball well and accurate from the outfield. Tracks balls down really well, and he's a really aggressive outfielder. He's one of those guys that can make your pitching staff a lot better out there.
Talk about his pitching. I mean, him being a left-handed pitcher, that's going to be probably his biggest strength for his college coach, right?
Bryce is really efficient with all of his pitches. He pounds the strike zone. He works in, he works out, pitches to contact, and does a real good job with holding base runners. And before you know it, you know, you're in the fifth, sixth inning, he's got like 50, 60 pitches and one or two runs maybe given up, and he really does a good job of keeping the defenders on their toes, ready to make plays, and because of that, they make a lot of plays for him.
Okay, and we've kind of talked about this before. Bryce is also an outfielder. His bat, you know, with him being a 6-foot, 150-pound guy, not a lot of power behind that, but I got to tell you, already two games this year, he's hit a triple and a home run in high school ball. You know, what do you see? Is that a bat that can be something that can eventually be one of his strengths?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, just like any kid, I mean, you got to build up your strength. And Bryce is a hard worker. It's important to him. He really likes hitting. So because of his strong defense, that gives him a lot of opportunities with the bat. And I wouldn't be surprised if he figured it out.
All right, now one other guy, Marco Vasquez. You haven't seen him a whole lot, but you have seen him play a couple games for you on the AZ Warriors. Just kind of talk about this kid. You know, he's a right-handed pitcher. He doesn't throw all that hard, but he was his freshman year Cy Young for Centennial High School. Plus, he had a 102 ERA his sophomore year. What makes this guy so good and put up those kind of numbers?
Marco does a good job of pounding the corners. He pitches to the edge of the plate with his fastball. He'll throw his breaking ball at any point in time in the count, and that's what keeps hitters off balance, his ability to mix in his breaking ball with his fastball. And he's able to throw his breaking ball for a strike also.
Have you seen him at the plate much?
I have seen him some. Aggressive hitter, uses the whole field, and he knows some situational hitting, and he tries to do a good job at that.
Seems like a kid with a pretty good attitude as well, kind of some quiet confidence. You see that?
Absolutely. He's a good kid to be around. He's a good teammate. No disruptions at all from him. He's 100% into baseball when he's at the baseball field, and that's all you can ask for.
All right, and one other kid. I didn't tell you I was going to ask you about him, but it's your son, Nate Easley. You know, that's another kid we're helping out. Just kind of describe Nate. Not only he's your son, you got a lot of good things to say about him, obviously, but if you're a college coach and you're breaking down Nate, what do you see from him?
Nate has good instincts. He has good instincts on the bases. He has good instincts on defense. He's really quick out of his breaks. That's his biggest asset. He knows how to do the little things like bunt, hit and run, hit behind runners. He's that typical top of the lineup kind of guy, scrappy. And he'll grow into his body and he'll continue to get stronger and quicker. And, you know, he's got real potential.
17 years of a second baseman and he's an outfielder? What's going on with that?
Oh, I don't know. He'll eventually get there. We're not worried about that right now.
All right. Thanks so much, Damian. So that's been Real Recruits TV for this week. Next week, we're going to have some more highlights of games around all of our locations here with Real Recruits TV. As for now, go ahead and check out our Facebook page, website, Twitter, all of the above. And Damian, thanks again for being with us today. And we'll see you again next week. Thanks, guys.